Boris Becker down. He lost the first set to Paul Harhoof. But right now, the action in the grandstand here at the USTA's National Tennis Center. And let's go to our colleagues, Jim Nance and Tony Trabert.
Okay, Pat, the number one seed, Steffi Graf, 4-3 on serve. Iva Zviglarova from Czechoslovakia serving. Advantage Zviglarova.
Steffi got off to a quick start, broke serve and led 2-love, but Zviglarova came right back to break, and they've been on serve ever since.
Steffi, of course, has won 2 U.S. Opens, 88 and 89, which she won here in 88. It completed her Grand Slam. Check, moving up in the rankings, Tony, now 52nd in the world.
And she's a very good, solid ground strokes, and she's really staying in this match at this point because Steffi has made more errors, 14-7. And this gal handles the pace from Graf shots.
Back to deuce. Zviglarova has already taken as many games from Graf as Steffi allowed in her first two matches. Beauty.
We see good racket preparation by the young Czech. And that ball had plenty of pace, what we call a heavy shot, and just got down that line perfectly.
Advantage Zviglarova.
These two have never played before.
Serve in the first set. Here's a look at the draw for Steffi.
And obviously, as you move on in this U.S. Open, it can get tougher and tougher. Judith Wiesner or Labatt could be the next opponent, the winner of this match. Zina Garrison.
Finals here a year ago to Sabatini, came back and won at Wimbledon against Gabby this year. Oh.
One of the few excursions to the net by Graf off the short ball. See, her shot was not very deep, just barely cleared the service line, and she paid the price.
All 30-15.
As we see Graf in the U.S. Open, Jim, it'll be interesting to see how many errors she does make. Not that we're going to count the number, but I think her racket preparation is suspect. And as she plays better people that push her, she creates makes a lot of errors.
No, you can cite the French Open this year, Tony.
Right. She got to the semis and lost love in two, and just couldn't hit the ball in the court. Tried as hard as she could try, but just nothing worked.
Oh. There's a strong serve. Steffi holds serve. 5-4 in the first set for the number one seed. back at the grandstand, right alongside the stadium court. A court that at one time had a reputation as the upset court at the U.S. Open, although there have been no surprises this week. 15 love, Eva Spiglarova from Czechoslovakia.
Eva turned pro in 1989, so she's just sort of getting the experience. Steffi turned pro in 82, so she's had a lot more experience on the big circuit.
2 years ago, Eva was ranked 135 in the world. Last year, 95th.
Now 52nd.
52nd, so climbing. 15 all, second serve. Second set at the stadium court.
Harhus has an early break in the second set against Becker, having won the first. So the number one seed getting himself in trouble. Groff has to set points up.
30-40.
She maneuvers Spiglarova out of position. Now she comes in on a deep ball. Spiglarova on the dead run can't recover. And Graf blocks it into the open court and is now set point for the number one seed, Steffi Graf. There it is. First set to Graf. 6-4.
33-minute first set, almost as long as it took Graf to eliminate Catherine Mott in her second round match, Love and Love. Okay, first set to Graf. Let's go back over to the stadium court. Pat Summerall, Mary Carrillo.
Tennis center, which is sort of adjacent to the stadium where Mary Carrillo and I am, Pat Summerall. Over there, Tony Trabert and Jim Nance. That place is packed, and this place is filling. That's the situation with Spiglarova. 5-love in the second set. And we'll be back to see what is going to happen over there. Right now in the stadium, Boris Becker, the number one seed.
Thank you.
With some difficulty. He lost the first set to Paul Harhus.
Tony Trabert. 4-2.
Pat, thank you. Graf leads 5-love, second set. And Spiglarova, hoping to at least salvage a game here, is now just a point away from losing the match. Advantage Graf. Match point here. It's been all Steffi in the second set here, Tony.
Her forehand has gotten on track a little bit better. She's hit some winners. And she really has worked the points a little bit better. She has been a little more patient trying to set the thing up. Spiglarova doesn't move real well. So when Graf plays up and down the court, Spiglarova doesn't have a real problem. That was Steffi's mom you just saw there in the picture. And so when she moves around, gets a little bit of an angle, she's more effective.
Steffi gets it back to deuce. Oh, we saw Heidi Graf. No signs of Peter. Deuce.
Big Grove's first serve is very flat. She doesn't get a lot of them in. She'd be better off with a little spin.
Eva
Stiglarova, 20-year-old Czech, who has advanced to the third round for the first time here at the U.S. Open.
She won in Auckland this year. First pro win.
She made it to the... Well, there's a game she salvages. Stiglarova had made it to the third round before the French and at Wimbledon back in 89.
Everything else been a first round loss to this point.
So now Steffi will serve for the match. 5-1 in the second. Love 15 approaching 1 hour into the match.
Pavel Slozil is Steffi's coach. I've had a lot of good conversations with him. Nicely done. Love 30.
Tony, in the bottom half of the draw, Jennifer Capriati has advanced to the fourth round already with a win yesterday. You like Capriati's chances here, don't you?
I do. I picked her to win. That's pretty tough pressure for a 15-year-old. As all of a sudden, Graf's down three break points.
Meanwhile, over on the stadium court, Becker held his serve, but Harhu still leads in the second set, 4-3.
That's with a break. Harhu's having won the first set. That put a lot of pressure for Becker. You know, he stays on the baseline a lot, and he says, I want to be a complete player, but he gets himself in a lot of trouble.
Second serve, 15-40.
The break for Stiglarova. Graf leads in the second set, 5-2.
Blown the high humidity away. The haze has left us. Here in the clear, Steffi Graf trying to close out her third round match after winning the first set 6-4 against Eva Stiglarova.
That weather change would certainly be a welcome news for the players because it's been very hot and very humid.
30-15.
Been perhaps an advantage to Jimmy Connors to play both of his matches at night when it cools off a bit. Be cool the rest of the way today.
30 all.
Right on the line, 30 all. Steffi earlier had a match point 2 games ago.
Game.
Another game for Stiglarova.
Graf leads 5-3.
5-3 Graf for the second set. High toss of Steffi.
Extremely high. It's in. She's a number one player in the world, won the Grand Slam. But she does several things that you wouldn't coach. One is the toss on the serve, way too high. Preparation on her ground strokes is late. Yet it obviously works well for her. And that's one of the problems that Pavel Slozil has with Steffi. She said, why should I change these things? I'm number one in the world.
Love 30.
Steffi's been known to be stubborn a time or two.
Yep.
Back to the Harhus Becker match in a few moments. And now Becker has come back now in the second set.
Two break points now for Zviglarova. The second set. Now, let's get the update on the Becker match. Let's send you back over to Pat Summerall and Mary Carrillo.
Well, the situation here.
Two sets to love.
All right, Pat, certainly surprising on the stadium court. A surprising development here is Eva Zviglarova has now won five straight games here in the second set from Steffi Graf. We're at 5-all on serve. Tony, what's happened here? Steffi had a match point at
I think she's impatient.
Level.
She doesn't try to set the points up very well. She's made a lot of unforced errors. Zviglarova's hung in there, and she's good solid off the ground. Perhaps Steffi trying to put her away a little too quickly. The way Graf plays, because she does gamble and she goes for a lot of her shots, if she's on, you say, oh, look at those marvelous shots. If she's off, you say, what bad percentage tennis? Oh. Young Czech has hit a lot of tremendous two-handed backhands, and she's caught Graf by going down the line with some of them. Worked very well for her. Was power against power, both really hammering the forehands. There, the winner is almost 2-1 in Steffi's favor. And a service ace to go up 6-5 in the second set. At 5-6 in the second set. She's won the first point, so it's 15 love. Now 15 all. This has to really annoy Steffi Graf for her to let that 5-love lead get away.
Now 2 points from the match for Graf.
Tony, when Steffi won here to complete the first women's Grand Slam since Margaret Smith Court 1970, when she won here in 88. Was she that much better a player than she is? She's still winning Grand Slam events now.
30 all.
What has happened?
Well, I think the main thing is that the other players have caught up to her. There are more good players playing against her. The Celises, the Arantxa Sánchez, Vicarios, and so forth. And they're not afraid of her anymore. But mind you, the next year after Grand Slam, she won 3 out of 4. In 1990, she won the Australian. And this year,
Wimbledon.
She's won Wimbledon. So what most people think is a bad year is a good year for
anybody else.
Right.
That was long.
40.
And now we have a match point. Match point number 2 for Steffi Graf. Next, it appears, would be Wiesner out at court 17 leading.
Watch how nicely Zvigarova sets up for this backhand. She freezes Graf at the net. Graf doesn't know which way to go. Good disguise and good solid shot.
Deuce. Advantage Zvigarova.
This has got to be great for her confidence, Zvigarova, say, come back from love 5 down to get in this situation, trying to take it to a tie break against the best player in the world.
Double ball. And back to deuce.
Both of these players win about twice as many points when they get their first serve in as they do on their second serves. And as I mentioned earlier, in my opinion, Zvigarova's first serve is too flat, so she doesn't get a high enough percentage of them in.
Another one long.
And then she'll put some pretty good spin on this one.
Zvigarova again a point away from taking this to a tiebreak in the second set.
She's doing a terrific job because she's not just playing it safe. She's moving the ball around. She's her second serve that time was very near the center line. Backhand approach down the line is a tough shot.
Of this game.
Trying to get the ball deep. I don't think that was nerves so much as she knows she doesn't get it pretty deep. Graf's going to try to run around it and just clobber the forehand.
Deuce. She's had 4 double faults on the match. Make it 5. And now match point number 3.
Maybe it is nerves after all. This is when, if you could whisper in Zvigarova's ear, say, spin the first one in. Don't let her look at that second serve. It's exactly what she did, and she's still in this match.
Fourth time at deuce in this game.
Advantage. Groff.
Another match point for Groff. That's match point number three of this game. She had one earlier in the sixth game of this second set.
Another save. Here comes Graf. She doesn't get anything on this one, and it's short. Actually, the length wasn't as bad as I thought, but no pace on it at all. Advantage, Figlarova. That single shot has really kept her in this match, the two-hander down the line.
Aarhus, two sets up on Becker. On serve in the third.
Deuce.
Back to deuce. Come to a Grand Slam event like this and play, as you mentioned, the number one player in the world and have this kind of performance. Will this take Sviglarova? Confidence-wise, ability-wise?
Has to be a tremendous confidence booster for her.
Match point again.
Match point number four. This 20-year-old from Czechoslovakia really gets some great experience.
Oh. Yes, add a little more experience. Back to deuce.
Deuce.
She's really played this as if she said, look, I'm the underdog, so I can just go after it.
That overpowering move by Graf.
Pavel Slozil in the black in the front. Heidi Graf, upper right-hand corner, Steffi's mother.
Watching another match point. There you have it. Steffi Graf into the fourth round. One hour and 22 minutes, but a name to tuck away for the future, Eva Sviglarova, who arrived today at the Open. On to the round of 16 for Steffi, and why don't we head downstairs to our studio and our man, Tim Ryan.
Thank you, Jim. Well, not exactly an easy cruise for Steffi, even though she got through in straight sets. Had to stay out there a while against Eva Sviglarova, who did a very good job, 6-4 and 7-5. And certainly, as Tony pointed out, great experience for her, and she's somebody to watch in the future. Now, here's how it looks for Steffi. She is awaiting the outcome of the match between Judith Wiesner of Austria and Florencio Labat of Argentina, and Wiesner leading that match at the moment. And would be favored to win it. So it's probably going to be Graf and Wiesner in the round of 16. The Dutchman up two sets to love, and Steffi Graf.
Congratulations, Steffi. Not exactly a routine third round match for you. You were up 5-love in the second set. What happened?
Well, I didn't really play too aggressive, and she made some really great shots. She played awfully close to the lines. And she, from then on, she really went for the shots, and I didn't, and that was the difference.
How's your shoulder holding up?
No problems at all. It's been really good.
All right, congratulations again. Now let's go back to the studio and Tim Ryan.
And in women's action that has taken place here so far today, we saw Steffi Graf, the winner on the grandstand court, 6-4 and 7-5 over Eva Sviglarova of Czechoslovakia. And Steffi has advanced into the round of 16. Judith Wiesner, a winner over Florencia Labat, 6-4 and 7-5. And so it'll be Wiesner and Graf in the round of 16, as we see on the draw here on the women's side of our tournament to this point. Graf will next meet Wiesner. And down below there, you can see Conchita Martinez, the number 8 seed. She was a winner today over Patty Fendick, 7-5 and 6-3, and awaits the winner of Zena Garrison or Barbara Rittner. And Conchita Martinez, 7-5.